let me say this. On the issue, the manners of the deep state, deep state and the systems, I think those things are irrelevant. We are the deep state. Me, you, him, and the rest of the voters. Mm-hmm. And you know, when they come up and say, you know, we unless you become the official opposition, unless you must have tried this number of times, and they're making references of what happened in Zambia. I don't know that guy who tried how many times. That's not the case. This thing will be decided by the voters. And whether people gang up against the DP, whether people say that we are the deep state, we are the systems. No. For us, when you say Mchoro, we are talking to that person down there. We are Mama Mboga Uko Chini. And what counted will be the votes. And it's your vote, my vote, him, and the rest that is going to be counted. So, man, I know your deep state and those things will be very relevant in 2022. Secondly, President Uhuru is an outgoing president.
Yes.
And for me, I foresee where he will be just like the former president, Mwai Kibaki, who did a great job and walked out of the state house without supporting any of the party. And if Uhuru comes out, President Uhuru comes out and says that he's into this thing and he's going to support Raila for presidency, and he goes out to the crowd to start campaigning, my friend, UDA is going to gain more.
But don't you think that as an individual he has that personal responsibility?
I do not think so. I do not think so. He did what he was supposed to be done. And there were issues during his time, but he also did well in certain projects. You know, there are flagship projects that will be carried in his legacy. So I don't think he will be... I think it will be just like what Mwai Kibaki did, and just goes home.